Good morning. Welcome to our all-school Mass. We're so excited that you could join us to worship and celebrate the Eucharist together. Today's intention is for the St. Luke community. Please rise.
Everybody, and Happy New Year, and Happy Epiphany. We have a lot going on today. It's adding on to all this wonderful liturgical celebrations of the Christmas season is a commissioning of our principal. We're going to, Mrs. Berman has been selected as our new principal for the remaining of the year and for the following year. So we want to welcome Mrs. Berman and congratulate her for her excellent leadership, especially during this time of the pandemic. And today we also celebrate the feast day of one of our saints, André Bessette, a religious. We read from the Ordo that André died on January the 6th, 1937, at the age of 91. He was CSC, orphaned at the age of 12, known as the Healer and the Miracle Man of Montreal, where he founded the Oratory of St. Joseph, to whom he was dedicated and fostered devotion. Over 1 million people paid their respects at his death. So today we thank St. André Bessette for the life that he lived and the life that he encourages us to live as well. My brothers and sisters, as we gather together to prepare to celebrate this mystery of God's love, let us call to mind our own failures and ask our Lord for peace and pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite, Lord have,
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the nations by the guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we, who know you already by faith, may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Jerusalem, stand up and shine. Your new day is dawning, and the glory of the Lord shines brightly on you. The earth and its people are covered with darkness, but the glory of the Lord is shining over you. Nations and kings will come to the light of your dawning day. Open your eyes and look around. Crowds are on their way. Your sons are coming from distant lands, and your daughters are being carried like young children. When you see this, your faces will glow. Your hearts will beat fast and swell with pride. Treasures from over the sea and the wealth of nations will be brought to you. Your country will be covered with caravans of young camels from Midian and Ephah. And the people of Sheba will bring gold and spices in praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm is, Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Please help the King to be honest and fair, just like you, our God. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Let him be honest and fair with all your people, especially the poor. Lord, let every nation on earth will adore you. Force the rulers of Parish and of the islands to pay taxes to him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Make the kings of Sheba and Sheba bring gifts. Make other rulers bow down and all nations serve him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in the village of Bethlehem in Judea, Herod was king. During this time, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and said, "Where is the child born to be king of Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. Herod brought together the chief priests and the teachers of the law of Moses and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" They told him, "He will be born in Bethlehem, just as the prophet wrote. Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, you are very important among the towns of Judea. From your town will come a leader who will be like a shepherd for my people, Israel." Herod secretly called in the wise men and asked them when they had first seen the star. He told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, let me know. I want to go worship him as well." The wise men listened to what the king said and then left. And the star they had seen in the east went on ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They were thrilled and excited to see the star. When the men went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, they kneeled down and worshiped him. They took out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh and gave them to him. Later, they were warned in a dream not to return to Herod, and they went back home on another road. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Today we are celebrating the feast of the Epiphany. And as many of y'all know, growing up as Catholics, it's always on January the 6th. But because of what's happened is a lot of people weren't coming to church. They came to Sunday Mass, but they weren't coming to these Holy Day of Obligation. So what did the church do? They moved these Holy Day of Obligations, real important ones like the Epiphany, to Sunday. So that's why a lot of people say, when did they move the Epiphany to Sunday? You know, it's always been on January the 6th, right? I got that right. Okay, I was thinking the 7th in my head. I'm like, quit talking on there, you know? Come on, it's a 6th. You got it right the first time. But seriously, so what happens? Well, we moved it to Sunday because we know it's a Sunday of obligation. People will come to church on Sunday, but they won't come to church on Wednesdays. So that's why they actually moved it for that purpose. But a lot of us still celebrate January 6th as the Epiphany. In fact, I remember when I was in Covenant House working with the homeless kids in Los Angeles, a lot of the volunteers that I was working with celebrated Epiphany more than they would celebrate Christmas. They said, this is really the day because of the gift giving. That's a beautiful image. That's where we get the whole presents and open up. Santa Claus made it very popular with the kids. But it really began with the three wise men, the magi, the astrologers. You remember this year, they said, oh, it hasn't been since 800 years that we had the two planets that were over each other. They call it the Star of Bethlehem. And they say that really was the star that led the magi to the baby Jesus in Bethlehem. But it's a beautiful image, the whole nativity scene, and this is a continuation. And everybody says, okay, when do we get to take down the Christmas tree? When do we stop singing Christmas carols? You know, when do we go back to ordinary time? And a lot of people say it's the Epiphany, right? Doesn't the Epiphany end the Christmas season? It's actually not. Does anybody know when it ends? The baptism of the Lord. So that's actually this coming Sunday. So this coming Sunday, you could finally take down the Christmas tree, okay? And if you already have already taken it down, you can come to confession after Mass with Father Eric. I'm just kidding. We won't hold that against you. But it is the Christmas season still. That's why we said Merry Christmas, everybody, because we're celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. The incarnation, the greatest miracle ever to occur, the Word become flesh and dwelt among us. We celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And it's a beautiful image of the nativity scene, the three wise men, the magi, bringing their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold representing the gift for the kings, the kingly person of Jesus. They recognize the King of the universe, the King of all kings. Christ the King has been born in our midst, and we bring him gifts of gold. Frankincense is a gift for the priestly person, that we recognize that Jesus is the priest of all priests. He is the bridge between heaven and earth. He's that connection between God and the people. The Word become flesh and dwelt among us. So they bring him gifts of frankincense. And then you have the gifts of myrrh. Myrrh is the oil that you anoint, the anointed one, and Jesus is the anointed one. But it's also used for embalming. But at the time of Jesus, they didn't have the materials and the equipment that we do now. So they would put the myrrh with the body, the dead bodies, in a way of embalming. And it's very interesting how we're talking about birth and life, but yet the embalming leads us to the cross. You can't have this without making reference to that. Life and death, they go hand in hand together. And there's a birth taking place. There's a death happening as well. We're in the middle of a pandemic, and a lot of us are seeing the death rates going higher and higher. In fact, in the beginning, I used to always hear, do you know anybody who has been infected? I don't know anybody. Is this for real? Or is this another government, shakeup trying to scare everybody? In the beginning in March, everybody was wondering, what's going on? Do you even know anybody? Now here we are in 2021, and everybody knows somebody, whether it was immediately affected in your own family or your friends or your workplace that has been tested positive for COVID-19, but even someone who's even known someone who has died from it. So we've all been affected. Many of us have not been infected, but we've all been affected. So now we're very blessed that there is a vaccine going around. And I said, who needs to be on the front line is our teachers. So I was very happy to see many of our teachers going and getting the vaccine during the Christmas holidays. And hopefully many of us will be vaccinated so that we have a sense of normality. And what is that going to look like? We don't know yet. There's so much uncertainty. There's so much death. There's so much life going on still in the midst of a pandemic. So in the midst of life, in the midst of death, there's God. And you shall call him Emmanuel, for God is with us. And that's the good news, that we are still practicing our faith. We're still teaching the children. We're still going on with our lives. Yes, there's concerns about the pandemic. Sure, there's concerns about death and dying. But there's still babies being born. There's still life happening. And we still continue to live life. I remember a cousin of mine who lost her child, her eldest son. And every single day, she would go to the cemetery. For 2 years, rain, sleet, or shine, she would go to the cemetery. And after those 2 years, I remember asking her, how is it now? Have you gotten over the deaths of your son? She said, I'll never get over the deaths of my son. She said, life is bittersweet. It's sweet because we still celebrate Christmas and Easter and the anniversaries and the birthdays. But it's bitter because it's without him. Life is bittersweet for many of us who have been affected by the coronavirus, who have lost loved ones, who have lost jobs, who have lost our normality in life. We've all been affected, but life continues to go on. And what continues is our faith. You can almost see this almost like a test, like God is tested, like he tested Job. Go ahead, take all this stuff away from him. Let's see how he remains faithful through it all. How are we remaining faithful through it all? That's really the question at hand. Mother Teresa said, God never expects us to be successful in life, but he does expect us to be faithful. Faithful to the gospel and faithful to his son, Jesus Christ. So today as we celebrate the Epiphany, what is the Epiphany? It's that aha moment of the manifestation of God amongst us. Is that moment that you realize that there's something greater happening here. There's something more important. This is so important in our own lives that, yes, my life is important, but there's something even greater than my own life, and that's God's presence. And how am I living according to God's plan? And I think that's very important because we all had our plans of what it was going to be like to be teachers, what it's going to be like to be students, what it's going to be like to be parents during this year. And those plans have been changed. So how are we being flexible in the ways of rolling with the changes? How are we being creative? How are we still teaching our children? How are we still keeping the faith? That's what matters. That's how we are being called, not just to be the servants of the Lord, but to be his disciples. And how are we being his disciples if we're not the faithful ones? If we're saying, I can't do this anymore, I lost my faith. And that happens along the journey sometimes. But how do we get back on board? How do we find Christ in the midst of darkness? Where is that light? And that's what the Epiphany reminds us, that light. That light that Christ brings into the world. That light that we have since the time of our baptism, we have the light of Christ. You are the light of the world. What are you doing with that light? How do they know that we're Christians if we're not living out the life that God has given us? So today we celebrate the Epiphany of the Lord, but it's not just His Epiphany. It's our Epiphany. It's our journey. See, what I loved about the three wise men is they traveled a great distance in search of something greater than themselves. And when they found it, they brought their gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. But then they had a dream to go back a different way. See, when we have that Christ encounter, our lives are changed forever. It's no longer I that live, but it's Christ that lives in me and through me and with me. Those are Paul's words. Why? Because Paul got it. He understood what it means to be a faithful servant of God. He understands what it means to live the gospel message. He understood what it means to be a disciple of Jesus. We as teachers, we as parents and students, we have this responsibility of keeping the building of the kingdom of God alive. We all have our part. The question is, are we doing it? And if we're not, then it's time to get busy. Today is the Epiphany of the Lord, but it's our Epiphany. It's our aha moment. It's a wake-up call to realize that we are created in the image and likeness of God, that we have a purpose, and it's time to put that purpose to use. Amen? This time we're going to be doing the commissioning of the principal within the Mass.
Father Eric, I present for commissioning Nadine Berman, who will serve the gospel of Jesus Christ through our school ministry as principal of St. Luke Catholic Church.
Nadine, can you please come forward? Nadine, you have been appointed as a partner in this congregation of schools to serve, support, and tell the story and nurture the people of God in faith and witness. We surround you with prayer and encouragement on this day, praying that God's Spirit may bless and inspire your leadership and example to the praise of God's grace for the work of ministry. Before Almighty God, in the presence of the assembly, I ask you, will you accept the ministry to be the principal of St. Luke Catholic School, believing that you are called by God to faithfully serve in the ministry of education? Will you witness to Jesus Christ in word and deed, pray for God's people in peace, serve diligently those you are commissioned to care for, and teach by your own example, encourage this community in faithful service and holy living? People of God, will you support Ms. Berman in this ministry, pray for her work, and seek to strive for unity and joy in the work of making Christ known through this ministry of learning and leadership? May God, who has given you the will to accept this position and allow the Holy Spirit to lead you to educate and discern what is the best interest for St. Luke Catholic School, graciously give you the strength and compassion to perform your duty as principal of St. Luke Catholic School. The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Amen. I invite everybody to extend your hands upon Ms. Berman as we give her our blessings. Lord our God, in your wisdom and love, you surround us with the mysteries of the universe. In times long past, you sent us your prophets to teach your laws and to bear witness to your undying love. You sent us your Son to teach us by word and example that true wisdom comes from you alone. Send your Spirit upon Nadine as the new principal and all the students who will study at St. Luke Catholic School under her leadership, their families, and their teachers, and fill them with your wisdom and blessings. Grant that during the remainder of this academic year, they may devote themselves in their studies and share what they have learned from others. Bless Ms. Berman and the students and teachers and all the parents. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Let's give her a round of applause. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful. My brothers and sisters, as we give thanks for God's blessings, let us offer our prayers for each other and for all in need.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's grace in Christ, the Shepherd, will guide our Pope, our Archbishop, our priests, and all those who serve our parish. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That God's grace in Christ, the peacemaker, will uphold world leaders and local officials in their work for peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
That God's grace in Christ, the Liberator, will deliver those who are hurting, hungry, or homeless. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers. That God's grace in Christ, the Healer, will deliver all of those who are affected by the coronavirus pandemic in our community, our country, and throughout the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers.
That God's grace in Christ, the Savior, will enlighten all of us who worship here and at home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's grace in Christ, the life-giver, will be the light for all who have known darkness and fear. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Mrs. Berman, who was just commissioned as our principal, for the remaining year and for the new year, that she will always be guided by the light of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for our own intentions, which we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, grant us the riches of your grace in answer to these prayers, that we will rejoice in your Son who dwells forever and ever. Amen.
Incense to offer have I, incense on a deity nigh. Prayer and praising gladly, praising worship him God on high. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, blissful leading, still proceeding, guide us to the perfect light. Glorious now, stars. Oh, star
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church in which we offer now, not gold, not frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so as angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Luke, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. As we stand together with faith and confidence in eternal life, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. During this time of communion, once again, we invite everybody to please wear your mask at all times. If you're receiving communion today, we only receive in the hand, not in the mouth. And once you receive in the hand, you may remove your mask, consume, and then put your mask back on. If you're not receiving communion for whatever reasons, we invite you still to come forward for a blessing. By simply putting your arms across your chest, myself and Eucharist minister will give you a blessing. Once again, thank you for your participation and your patience during this time of the pandemic. Thank you. Pray this act of spiritual communion for our brothers and sisters who are not able to join us. And we pray, My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Archbishop gave this beautiful prayer to Our Lady Guadalupe to pray during the pandemic. We've been praying it throughout the year. And we want to continue to pray until that we don't have to pray no longer. Okay, so if you have the prayer, I know Michelle's going to put it on the screen for those who are on Facebook Live. And together, let us pray. Our Lady of Guadalupe, in these times of tribulation, we turn to you, O Mother. See with compassion the suffering of your beloved sons and daughters, affected by the coronavirus pandemic throughout the entire world. Ask your Son to have mercy on us, bringing healing to those infected and protection to all your children. Jesus Christ, Savior of all people, grant us courage to accompany and care for the entire world in the wake of sorrow and uncertainty. We seek refuge in you, and according to your promise, deliver us from this danger. Amen. St. Anthony of Padua,
pray for us.
St. Luke,
pray for us.
Once again, we want to welcome back our teachers after the Christmas holidays and our administrators and our students and our parents. Thank you for continuing to support Catholic schools. And just want to welcome y'all back. It's good to see y'all back. I want to see more kids in the classrooms, hopefully this following the week. I miss not having the kids in mass, but I know hopefully they'll be watching it on Facebook Live in their homes and in the classrooms next week as well. Thank y'all, everybody, and once again, Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
The Lord be with you!
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The celebration is ended. Let us now go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much, Father Eric, for that really inspiring homily. I know the times are dark right now, but there is a lot of light. There is a lot of light. So this year, we're going to follow that light, and we're going to surround ourselves with that light and continue to be productive and positive as we go forward the rest of this year. It's easy to get wrapped up in the dark. It's very easy to do that. It's a lot harder to brush the dark aside and reach out for the light. And so I think we can all be together as a team and as a family, and we can get through this year and have a lot of positive experiences. So I look forward to that with each of you and all the students and the parents at home. It's a wonderful blessing to be a part of a Catholic school and a Catholic community. It's a true blessing. That is the light that's going to surround us. I'd like to go ahead and conclude with our three Hail Marys. So if Ms. Gonzalez could lead us, thank you. God bless. Have a wonderful day.